Tasmanian devil is the world's largest carnivorous marsupial. It's about the size of a small dog. And it lives only on the island of Tasmania, which is that small island just to the south of the mainland of Australia. And the Tasmanian devil is now undergoing a really rapid population decline, and that's because of the emergence of a new disease, which is an infectious cancer. The cancer was first observed in 1996 in the northeast of Tasmania, and quickly it spread to other parts of Tasmania. Now the population has declined by between 60 and 70%.
Tasmanian devil cancer is a highly unusual tumour because this particular cancer is spread from animal to animal. The actual cells are inoculated from the tumour of one Tasmanian devil into the next one because they engage in biting each other through feeding practices and through mating.
We've been very interested in the genetics of the Tasmanian devil transmissible cancer because it's actually one cancer that arose once in one devil and has now spread through the population, almost like it's metastasized through the entire population. Our genomic work has allowed us to do some genetic detective work to understand the identity of that original devil that first gave rise to the cancer. And our work suggests that that devil was a female, that she probably lived on the east coast of Tasmania relatively recently. I call her the Immortal Devil because although she is now dead, the descendants of her cells and her DNA are still present in the cancers of thousands of devils around Tasmania today.
So the evidence that we have at the moment is that the immune system of the Tasmanian devil, the animal itself, is intact and functioning properly. So there must be something within the cancer that allows it to evade the immune system. And we now should use the genome sequences that we've generated in order to find what it is that the cancer is using to escape immune surveillance.
In one particular population, we observed what looks like a selective sweep, which means that one cancer strain got overtaken by another one within the space of a few years, which suggests that the cancer is continuing to evolve.
It is not impossible that such a phenomenon could occur in human beings. We know that individual cancers have transferred between one human being and another. Thankfully, they have not spread beyond that. But by learning about what is unique about the Tasmanian devil cancer that allows it to spread through the whole species, we will be armed should such an event ever happen in human beings.
Well, what we plan to do next is to sequence more Tasmanian devil cancers and to look at how the cancers have spread and changed genomically over time and space. This is going to give us some detail into how transmissible cancers evolve and also more broadly how cancers themselves can evolve and change and adapt to their hosts over time. The future is looking quite bleak for the Tasmanian devil. The population is declining extremely fast and the disease is spreading into all the areas that are still unaffected. And so it's a race against time to find information and strategies and management interventions that can help save the devil from extinction before it's too late.